Welcome to the second video in this DIRCAM tutorial series. In this video, we'll introduce you to the DIRCAM workflow, the general sequence of steps to prepare input data for a single DIRCAM optimization. For now, we'll stick with a high-level description of each step in the process. In the next video, we'll show you what it looks like to implement each of these steps using the actual interface input fields and menus. This general overview is meant to serve as a roadmap to help you navigate the process of building a new DIRCAM model from scratch, as well as providing some practical advice on each step of the process. This is by no means the only way to use DIRCAM. As you gain familiarity with the tool, you may find alternative approaches more compatible with your workflow. Nevertheless, if you're completely new to the tool, this workflow should be a helpful starting point. The general workflow consists of 7 steps. Some steps can be completed quickly, while others require careful consideration of input data and modification of multiple data fields and tables. Ultimately, the complexity of each step will depend on the particular needs of your specific project. The 7 steps are: select either a single-node or multi-node model. Define site-specific data like loads and weather. Define the utility tariffs, rates, and export options. Define DER options and parameters. Once these inputs are defined, you'll run a reference case. This is the performance of the site in its current state. With a reference case complete, you can now enable consideration of new DER investments. Then run an investment case to allow DIRCAM to select new DER investments. That's the DIRCAM workflow at its simplest, but let's take a moment to discuss each of these steps in a little more detail. The first step of the process is to select either a single node or multi-node model. You will be prompted to make this selection whenever you create a new project. A single node model is usually the best option for starting a new design, even if you think you will eventually like to build a more complex multi-node representation of your project in DIRCAM. Single node models can be solved much faster and require less data to get started. They allow you to quickly assess design options before getting into more detailed modeling work. For multi-building sites, single-node models will generally work well when loads can be easily aggregated, the network capacity between buildings is high, losses or voltage concerns inside the microgrid network are not a top modeling priority, or the siting of DERs within the microgrid is not required as part of the design solution. If you select a multi-node model, you will need to define the network topology as part of the workflow. We'll provide some additional details on this process in a later video. At this time, DIRCAM doesn't allow users to switch from a single node project to a multi-node project after the model has initially been created. Going in the opposite direction, if you need to, a multi-node project can always be simplified down to a single node by removing all but one node and aggregating site data there. Please keep these facts in mind whenever starting a new project. The next step in the workflow is to define site characteristics. The most important site characteristics are load profiles and climate data, particularly those data relevant to determining solar generation potential. DIRCAM provides data libraries to help users quickly define some of these inputs. For load profiles, DIRCAM provides typical load profiles for 16 reference building types across 16 US cities, which are each representative of a distinct US climate zone. These load profiles are automatically segmented into different end uses, including heating, cooling, and direct electricity consumption, allowing DIRCAM to select technologies capable of serving each of these specific end uses. Each load profile can be scaled to a specific annual consumption of electricity and natural gas, allowing users to size the reference load profiles to their particular needs. Users can also elect not to make use of the load profile data library and instead import their own data. Recall, however, that DIRCAM uses a smaller set of design days, represented by monthly weekday, weekend, and peak day profiles. If users have external interval load data, they can use a tool available on our website to quickly convert to DIRCAM design day load profiles and copy these data directly into their model. We'll show you exactly how this can be done in a later video. To help users define site-specific data, DIRCAM also provides a data library with average monthly insolation for hundreds of US locations. For users looking to model sites outside of the US, we also provide a tool on our website to help you convert annual weather or climate data into the monthly profile format used by DIRCAM. Again, we'll walk you through the details of this process in a later video. For users looking to model a specific solar PV configuration, DIRCAM also allows for the use of normalized PV output profiles. If you fall into this category, then you can elect not to import reference solar data. We'll show you how to customize the representation of your solar PV system in a later video. With the site characteristics defined, the next step is to define the energy cost landscape. This means defining your site's tariff structures and rates, fuel costs, export options, and any other energy market details that might be relevant to your project. For tariffs, DIRCAM is able to capture a wide variety of tariff structures, including flat rates, tiered rates, time of use rates, monthly demand charges, system peak demand charges, and real-time prices. DIRCAM includes a number of input tables that allow you to select which of these tariff structures apply to your project and to define the rates for each of them. When starting a new project, DIRCAM also allows you to automatically populate these tables from a collection of dozens of US tariffs. However, tariff structures, and especially rates, change often. These reference tariffs are meant to serve as starting points. We generally recommend that users update these values to ensure they accurately reflect the current energy costs of their specific projects. There are a number of helpful resources to look up electricity tariff rates, including the utility rate database from OpenEI. With site and tariff information defined, the next step is to define parameters for DER technologies. If you've been using reference data from DIRCAM's data libraries, this is the first step you will need to complete outside of the new project menu. Key values you'll need to define include the cost of the DER technologies, including fixed and variable capital costs and operations and maintenance costs, and DER performance data, items like capacities, efficiencies, lifetimes, etc. Again, DIRCAM provides default cost and performance data for a wide variety of DER technologies, including solar PV, battery storage, and dozens of generator and CHP technologies. You can proceed with these default values, or you can update them to better reflect the DER technologies you're considering for your project. At this time, you should also define any existing DER technologies at your project site. If, for instance, there is a solar PV array already in place, you can add that capacity here as an existing investment, so that your reference case accurately reflects your project site as it currently exists. Once this is complete, you're ready to run your model as a reference case. The reference case provides a point of comparison for subsequent investment cases, allowing you to determine changes such as energy cost savings and CO2 reductions from new DER investments. All you need to do is run the model and examine the results. Make note of the total annual energy costs and annual emissions reported in the results dashboard. We encourage users to save these results if they're interested in examining more detailed comparisons between cases. With the reference case complete, you can now move on to your new DER investments. This means enabling new DER technology types to be considered for investment. Ultimately, it's up to you as the user to determine which technology types you want DIRCAM to consider. You can globally enable technology types like solar, storage, generators, and then specifically enable different technologies of that type. For instance, you may be interested in a variety of storage options, but only one generator type. DIRCAM gives you a high level of control in selecting which technologies are enabled. Furthermore, if you want to examine a specific design solution, you have the option to force investments in any DER technologies, instead of allowing DIRCAM to optimize the selection. Once you are satisfied with your new DER investment options, you need only run the model again. Now, the results dashboard will provide you a detailed breakdown of investment and performance metrics for the new optimized design. For more detail, you can also explore the text-based result file produced by the optimization and copied from the DIRCAM server to your local machine. This step concludes the basic DIRCAM workflow. While some of the information presented in this video might feel abstract, it will make more sense as you work through the construction of a model yourself. In the next video, we'll put this workflow into practice by building a simple DIRCAM model. As always, if you have questions on the information presented here, please reach out to us at dircam@lbl.gov.